Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Handsport Forum here in Neubrandenburg, Germany. The feature bout this evening is brought to you by Ransett Ains Boxing and Soland Event. The fight is sanctioned by the WBA. Your supervisor at ringside from Colombia, Rodolfo Fortis. Introducing to you the three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Spain, Manuel Oliver Palomo. From Panama, David Singh. And from Sweden, Michael Hook. And your referee in charge of the action at the bell. From the USA, Rafael Ramos. Great fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBA Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance, and the boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Neubrandenburg, Germany, it's time to rock and roll! Introducing to you first, fighting out the red corner, wearing the red trunks. He weighed in at 79.2 kilos. He has a fight record of 29 wins, just 3 losses. 15 wins by knockout. From Wales, the challenger, Nathan Cleverly. And his opponent across the ring, wearing the red trunks, he weighed in at 78.5 kilos. He has a fight record of 48 wins, just 2 losses, and 35 wins by way of knockout. Please welcome the WBA Light Heavyweight Champion of the World, from Germany, Jürgen Bremer!
Fairly lengthy introductions. Nathan Cleverly being made to wait a good while in the ring, though, as is Jürgen Bremer. Both of these two just pacing a little nervously. They just want to get into the action now. Hear that first bell.
You see the pre-fight instruction. I give you my command. Give me a clean fight. Protect yourself. Let's do it.
Cleverly looked nice and relaxed during his ring entrance, but now he's got his game face on. The early stages of this fight, so very, very important when he has been beaten, Bremer, and it's only happened a couple of times against Mario Veit and against Hugo Hernan Gray as well. It's been because the other fighters out-hustled him, outworked him, and Cleverly immediately onto the front foot here. We've been talking about this in the last few minutes, and the boys in the studio, he cannot allow Bremer to settle. He cannot allow Bremer to fight at his pace, because generally, whoever dictates the pace wins the fight. It's not always that simple, but most of the time it is.
Yeah, straight down to business here. Nathan Cleverly looks, you know, full of belief all week, looks right up for it here tonight, Bruno. The introductions, as you can see, there was a real spring in his step, and he's come out quick out the blocks here, looking to apply pressure, looking to close the distance, and I think that's important. He needs to keep Bremer under pressure. He needs to force a pace, force a high tempo, and he needs to make it his type of fight. He needs to get in close, stay close to the chest of Bremer, and make it a war of attrition, really. I think that's what he needs to do to win this fight. Bremer, on the other hand, wants to keep it at distance, wants a slower pace, wants it to be a thinking man's fight, and wants to drive home that backhand and keep Cleverly in his place. And he's already landed his set a couple of times in this fight. You know, it's going to be interesting as this fight goes, who can dictate the terms in there.
Well, Cleverly at the moment just trying to put Bremer under pressure with that front foot. He's always inching forward, just crowding into space, just getting into that kind of half three-quarter range. Bremer trying to take the odd step back and give himself a little bit more room to work that southpaw jab, and with it the backhand. But what have you made of these opening stages, Carl?
Straight down to business, Cleverly. I like what he's doing, backing up Bremer, or at least trying to back him up. He's got the centre of the ring, he's putting Bremer on his back foot. He's landed, actually, he's had some success with his right hand to the body and to the head. Bremer having to tuck up tight. If Cleverly can maintain this is a fantastic start.
Well, we saw against Bonfara, he was up by 2 rounds on 2 of the cards after 6 rounds, Cleverly, but the nose went, it was broken, shattered really in the 7th round, and after that the fight got away from him. He showed plenty of heart that night, maybe was a bit too macho at times, beating the chest, inviting Fonfara in. He's got to be a little bit more clever against the likes of Jürgen Bremer. But the body language from Cleverley, and body language in a fight like this can be important for the judges, not just for yourself. We did talk about how hard it is to go and win in Germany. The man next to me will testify to that. But I think at times we can become a bit obsessed by it. It's hard to go and win away anywhere, including the UK.
Yeah, I think Cleverley just needs to focus on the fight, control the controllables. He can't control what the judges do or how they see the fight. He just needs to make sure that he fights the best fight he can. And so far, that's exactly what he's doing. You know, he's getting close. He's getting combinations off. He's working the body. You know, it's a high pace. He's got to be careful. You know, Bremer looking to land that backhand there again. Just slipped outside Cleverley's jab and tried to land his own backhand. He's got to be careful of that. But very positive start here from Cleverley. This is exactly the type of fight we want to see coming from him.
Cleverley just winding up that right hand as the bell goes at the end of the first. Well, in the corner there of Jürgen Bremer, the advice coming in. And it was an interesting first round that we just saw some action from it, and we just saw glimpses there as well of Cleverley's front foot, just stepping on the front foot of Bremer, which is an occupational hazard, of course, when an orthodox fighter fights a southpaw. He hasn't actually been in with a southpaw since Tommy Carpensi in 2012, Cleverley, but he's been sparring Jamie Cox, who's 20-0 at super middleweight these days. And Bremer's just come out at the start of the second round a bit more aggressive, stiff with that jab and looking for the backhand.
Yeah, well, I think he realises he can't allow Clever just to walk in on top of him, unleashing, you know, five and six punch combinations. That's the type of fight he doesn't want to happen. He can't let it become that type of fight, because if he does, he's fighting Cleverley's fight. You know, so straight away at the start of this round, he's looking to really bang in some power shots, looking to subdue Cleverley. Great uppercut there from Cleverley on the inside. This is where he needs to be. This is exactly the type of fight that Nathan Cleverley wants. Jürgen Bremer, from his point of view, he needs to get some distance between the two. He needs to bang some hard backhands straight down the middle and keep Cleverley in his place. But this is a great positive start from Nathan Cleverley.
Cleverley had good success with that uppercut against Fonfara. He's been out of the ring since then, clubbing right hand to the side of the head there from Cleverley as well, just tucked up and through a left hook. But Bremer getting through with a couple of backhands there and just a coupling left thrown from the waist as well that gets the home crowd going. But it's a good start, this, from Nathan Cleverley. He doesn't want to get too overexcited. We did see him wind up for a bolo in that first round, but he's putting his punches together nicely at the moment, and he's making, currently, Bremer fight the kind of fight that we haven't seen him in for quite some time.
Yeah, he's just got to be careful of that backhand from Bremer. You know, he's been looking to really drive it home right down the middle, right down the pipe on several occasions. Just fell short a couple of times and Cleverley just got outside it on others. But that's the potent weapon from Bremer. That's the danger punch. But so far, so good. This is exactly the type of fight that Nathan Cleverley wants.
Bremer at times just taking a little bit too long to get off. The output is good from Cleverley, but as you say, he does have to be careful of that backhand. He can do damage with it, Bremer.
Jürgen Bremer here, matching Cleverley, standing in front of him, staying inside the pocket, up close, in punching range. And he's getting hit with four more shots from Cleverley. Cleverley's still working well, still being busy. I'm just concerned, can he maintain his pressure and his work rate over 12 rounds? Because he's going to need to, because Bremer will be there.
That's the punch Cleverley's got to be careful from there. Right there, Bremer just slips outside of Cleverley's lead punch and then comes back with his own counter, backhand straight down the middle. He's looking for it all night long. It's only two into the second round here, but he's looking for it already. And it's a shot he'll look for all night because it's his honey punch. But this is the type of fight, this is the right thing that Nathan Cleverley needs to be doing. He's finding a rhythm, he's getting good momentum in the fight, he's getting his confidence into it. And so far, you know, I'm happy with Nathan Cleverley's work.
And the crowd just beginning to get into this. At the end of the second round, it's been a good opening.
Go for your exchange, Ed. You're just nicking these rounds, but don't make them too
well. Interesting advice coming in from Darren Wilson in the corner there, saying to Cleverley that he can take a step back every now and again and just box, just give himself a little bit of distance. He doesn't have to be on top of him all the time, showing how tough he is, and that's good advice, I think.
Yeah, very good advice. I mean, I think it's the type of fight Cleverley wants. I don't think he won that round. I thought Bremer landed the cleaner work, the better punches, the quality came from Bremer. But
I think it's the type of fight that Nathan Cleverley wants. He wants it to be a high-tempo fight. He wants it to be standing in the center of the ring with him, trading body shots and uppercuts. He just needs to make sure that he is winning the rounds as well and not coming off second best. But this type of pace, this type of fight, this is what Nathan Cleverley wants.
Cleverley working well, throwing a lot of punches, but a lot of punches are being landed on the gloves and arms of Bremer. Bremer getting through there with that southpaw left cross, which is bad news for Cleverley this early on. He saw it there at the end of round two, was getting caught with that southpaw left cross. Even though he's working harder and taking a lot of energy out, you don't necessarily have him winning round two. And the judges, you know, they're looking for everything Bremer does, and he's got a very good defence, Bremer, so they won't really be looking to score Cleverley's shots. And with left crosses like that landing on Cleverley's chin, it's bad news. I mean, good response here from Cleverley's landing uppercuts and hooks, just throwing arm punches, and he's busy there on the head of Bremer. But I don't know if this sort of tactics at this stage for Cleverley are going to work for him. He's getting hit with a lot of shots far too often for me.
Well, at the minute in this round, Bremer's just managed to establish just that touch of distance that he needs. It's just half a step back, and Cleverley's just not quite on top of them as he was before. We heard what Darren Wilson said in the corner, that maybe he doesn't want to be there all the time, but at the moment Bremer's just managed to open up that bit of a gap, which is giving him room.
Well, I think Bremer's doing the right thing. You know, from his point of view, he's, you know, Cleverley's come out, he's all guns blazing, starting really quick, trying to force the pace. Bremer's standing his ground now, giving Cleverley something to think about, driving back some hard body shots, you know, some straight lefts right down the middle. He's realised if he stands back and tries to box too much, he'll allow Nathan Cleverley to just bully him, and he's refusing to let Cleverley bully him. He's standing his ground, and he's getting Nathan Cleverley's respect. Very interesting fight, intriguing fight as it's unfolding now, and it's all to play for. So it's just who can force the pace, and who can dictate the terms in there. And so far, it's not clear who that's going to be.
Good stuff there from Cleverley as we enter the final minute of the third round. Just caught Bremer with a right, then followed by a left. Bremer again just looking to throw short, sharp left hands himself. And this is gritty, grueling stuff as Bremer again just steps into another left. He does stand quite tall as he throws it. Caught a little bit square at times, but he's tucking up nicely there. The left hand coming in from Cleverley, whose arms are just moving almost constantly as we head into the final 30 seconds of round three.
I get the feeling Cleverley's almost working for the sake of working, throwing these punches. A lot of them are arm punches, but they're not going to impress the judges. They're not snapping back the head of Bremer. Bremer seems to be landing the eye-catching punches like these. Right hooks and his left cross is going through. I just feel like Bremer's making a more impact on these rounds, scoring-wise.
We're talking about Gudjic. Well, Jürgen Bremer, apart from one fight in Hungary, is for his entire career in Germany, which is maybe one of the reasons why he doesn't get as much credit as possibly he could do. You look at the likes of Sven Otker, who fought his entire career in Germany, apart from one fight, I think, in Austria. He retired as an undefeated world champion. And you look at Bremer's record, and it is absolutely excellent. The scale of the task here for Nathan Cleverley is big. You look at British fighters who come to Germany and unseated German world champions. Glenn Catley did it back in 2000, a 12th round stoppage of Marcus Beyer. Carl Thompson did it on the card, split decision 3 years before that against Ralph Boccagiani for the WBO cruiserweight title. But it's a very, very difficult thing to do indeed, and Cleverley again has just stepped forward here, stepped onto Bremer, looking to try and work away on the inside. And at the moment, this is pretty similar to the fight we saw against Andre Fonfara.
Yeah, and I think Cleverley has to be happy with the way the fight's going. I mean, I thought he lost rounds two and three. I thought the quality came from Bremer, he landed the cleaner work. But as a pattern of how the fight is unfolding, I think Cleverley has to be happy with the way it is. He needs to be able to take one, to give one. I don't think he's going to stand back and outbox Jürgen Bremer over 12 rounds. I don't see that happening. So he needs to make it a high-tempo fight. He needs to force a pace. He's the younger man, you know, and he needs it to be a war of attrition. He needs it to be a very physical fight, fought at a fast pace. And that's the way the fight's unfolding. Yeah, I think he lost rounds two and three. But in terms of the way the fight is unfolding, I think it's becoming his type of fight. That's the type of fight he wants.
You look at the punch stats there. Punches thrown 337 by Cleverley, 201 by Bremer. Landed percentage-wise, slightly in favour of Bremer. Just a bit of tape leaning, sorting out on the glove there of the German, which gives these two a little bit of a break. Carlos Soundland in the background there, just watching on in rapt concentration. Eddie Hearn ringside also. Saw Tyrone Zuger on camera just not that long ago, super middleweight. trained by Jürgen Bremer at the moment. Bremer already training fighters, which is interesting, makes you think that he's thinking about a career post-fighting, but at the minute...
Which makes you wonder what his appetite will be, you know, down the stretch in his fight when the pace does get grueling. You know, cleverly working the body well there, really driving them home. And that's essential. That's something he needs to do because he's set a fast pace. He's going to have to keep it at a fast pace. And, you know, you wonder at 37, Jürgen Bremer is the older man and cleverly being the fresher guy. This is the type of fight that's going to suit Nathan Cleverly as the rounds progress.
Nice uppercut there on the inside from Cleverly. To land the right hand, he did land the right hand, but then just stood there and admired it a bit, and that left hand came straight back from Bremer, just snaking out from that backhand.
You know, again, I think Bremer's having the best of these exchanges. He's landing the cleaner work, he's landing the harder punches, the more eye-catching punches. Again, probably winning this round as well, but I think the way, the longer the fight goes, the longer the rounds go, you know, it becomes more Cleverly's territory. You know, he's the younger man, he's the fresher man, he's got a gamble, but he's going to be the fresher guy into the second half of the fight.
I think the punch stats we saw earlier sort of summed the fight up. Cleverly outworking Bremer, but not landing the eye-catching shots. You know, the scoring shots are going through the guard of Nathan Cleverly, and I think he's slipping behind here on the scorecards because Bremer's work is quite, you know, there's a lot of quality, some good quality punches landed from Bremer. I mean, Cleverly having good success here, driving forward and finishing really strong with some good shots here, right hand, left hook, close round.
Sit up, right? Keep changing the paces like you do at the end.
Let's see if we can just have a quick listen to this Cleverly corner.
Can't handle it. Right? He's fading, but keep smart, right? Keep smart. Don't take too many shots.
Tackle time! Both men back on their feet. Cleverly back on his feet pretty early. Michael. As they look to come out for the fifth round. Bremer turns 38 next week, but he's kind of looked the same for the last 10 years almost, really. Good jab there from Cleverly, snapped out at the start of the round. Really looking to try and dig to the body too. He covers up there, dropping the elbows, Bremer.
Yeah, good fight so far, Andy. I think, you know, Cleverly's going to be happy with how it's unfolded. You know, like I say, oh, great body shot. Really good left hook to the body. Really big, dug it in hard. He's been working the body well tonight, Nathan Cleverly, and that's something he needs to keep doing.
Bremer answers right back there. There were some body shots of his own, and he finished with a nice headshot. Left hook, uppercuts going in here. Nathan Cleverly on his back foot, taking heavy shot, but really, he doesn't want to be taken at this stage. Cleverly is setting the pace, and he's looking to work the aging Bremer, but I'm not sure it's going to be enough. Good work here from Cleverly, though. It's a great fight, this one. Exchanges back and forth from both men.
Well, there were an awful lot of punches thrown in his last fight against Bonfara. 2,500 between, and Bremer getting through with a stiff left hand there, though he has done a few times this round. Cleverly has done plenty of good work of his own. He's looking quite often to finish on that left to the body, just not quite tip-tapping upstairs, but keeping his hands busy and then really putting something into that left, trying to find a home for it just underneath that rib cage, find that floating rib. Both of these two in good shape. He's actually the lightest he's been since he became WBA champion, Bremer, but only by a pound or so I don't think we can read too much into that. Cleverly seemed to make the weight comfortably enough. Bremer choosing his reflexes there and then trying to fire back on Cleverly. Possibly slightly low with the left there, Bremer, but you could say the same for the Welshman as he answered back.
I'd say it's a great fight here so far. You know, we're into the fifth round and there's been some action, a lot of leather thrown already. And, you know, you would like to think that this is going to be the type of fight that Nathan Cleverly wants. He came out, he initiated this kind of fight. He was straight out of the block, straight over from his corner into Bremer's, forcing the pace, making Bremer fight every second of every round. And, you know, like I say, even the rounds he's losing, he's really making Bremer work really hard to win them. And sometimes it's okay to lose a round as long as you make the other guy work so hard to win it that it's going to affect him in the second half of the fight. And I think that's what Nathan Cleverly's tactics are here. Obviously, he has to make sure that he doesn't take too much damage in the process. But so far, this fight is really warming up to his type of fight.
We're heading towards the final 30 seconds of round five. And this one in particular has been a brutal round. They've just stood in front of each other and traded leather, really. They both landed plenty of good, hard, spiteful shots as Cleverly goes down to the body again. The crowd are absolutely loving this. Bremer just banging with the left hand to the torso of Cleverly as well, but this is going to take quite a lot out of both of these two.
I think the difference for me, though, is Bremer's punches look like they're having more of a telling effect. They look like heavier punches are landing, cleaner, more accurate, but more solid.
from Bremer.
Yeah, I think Carl's right. He is landing the better punches. I'm just thinking that the pace of the fight, that's what Nathan Cleverly wants. This type of fight is his type of fight.
Well, the crowd that you're on Sport Forum used to seeing Jürgen Bremer. He was in action here recently, and they really get behind their fighters in Germany. And we could have picked any passage, really, from this fifth round to show us as highlights, because this was just a sample of what we saw.
Yeah, great round, Andy. Like you say, you could have had the whole round played as a highlight reel. Lots of clean punches landing from both guys. I think that Bremer landed the better punches, probably won the round, but I just like the way the pattern of the fight's going. I think this kind of tempo, this kind of pace suits Nathan Cleverly more.
Bremer's really being made to work here by Nathan Cleverly. Nathan Cleverly setting a ferocious pace, and he's really going to ask the questions of the aging Bremer. And he's going to really have to work and dig deep hard late on. If Cleverly can keep this going, Bremer's going to have to work to keep his title. But I've got Bremer landing the cleaner shots and showing that at the minute he's the more classy fighter in terms of punches landed and accuracy, which is a key element for scoring.
Well, into round six, and Cleverly again just straight onto the shoulder of Bremer, who looks to try and just dip that chin behind his right shoulder, then almost leading with a right hook. He hasn't managed to get that southpaw jab into play because he's just been crowded for room. He's had to take half a step back at times and just give himself enough leverage to land that left hand, a step away to his left hand side there, Bremer, on the end of a good combination. And he's just caught Cleverly on the way in there a couple of times.
Yeah, Cleverly just got to be careful that he's not eating too many of these left hands from Bremer. Landed a good 1-2 straight down the middle there himself. But just got to be careful of Bremer's backhand. Landing a little bit too regular for my liking here.
Cleverly just looking to jab there for almost the first time. He does have a good jab. Got a good snappy left lead hand when he decides to use it. Just stuck out that right hand and held his feet ever so slightly. Work rate, of course, and fitness, as you've been saying, Carl, is going to play a big, big part in this. And Cleverly will be hoping that Bremer does slow, as Bremer just squares up a bit there as he throws that left hand.
I think Bremer's been very clever because he's always having the last answer of the argument. Cleverly's landing some nice shots and he's putting his word together, but Bremer just seems to land the eye-catching shot at the end of the exchange, and that's what's going to catch the eye of the judges. But you know, he's a quality fighter, Bremer. I didn't realize how cute he was up close, picking his shots nicely. He's got a good defense, tidy, blocking a lot of the shots on his gloves and arms. Cleverly getting through, landing shots, but that left hook from the southpaw position getting through, and the body shots as well from Bremer, which would tire the legs of Cleverly as we go down the stretch. But he's the younger man, Cleverly. He's obviously very fit, putting the shots together well and really backing Bremer up here. And you know, if he can just have some sort of dent on Bremer, then it will give him that hope that he needs to finish the round strong and finish forward. Because I don't know, I just feel it's not going his way at the minute. Even though he's working so hard, I feel like the fight's still not quite in his control.
Yeah, and Bremer looking to kind of get a bit more distance between the two of them now and trying to like pot shot a bit. Look, makes me think that maybe he's not too comfortable with the pace, which would be understandable because it's been a hellacious pace so far. Trying to work the backhand again, the straight shots down the middle, and you know, at times they're just lying on the rope, slipping and sliding the shots as opposed to coming back with punches. So maybe just feeling the pace here a little bit and just looking to steal a rest and just suck up and you know, fill his lungs with oxygen and just recuperate. I mean, he like I say, it's been a hectic pace, and I think both guys probably feeling it a little bit at this stage.
Again, some tape is just coming loose from the glove there of Bremer, just trying to get it permanently stuck down this time. Timeout called by the referee. Cleverly, of course, had that brief flirtation with the cruiserweight division, which I think most people said at the time, it wasn't just with hindsight, that was never really going to suit him. Came back down and has looked better since, and does look to be, as they did against Bonfara, plenty left. And he's talked about hunger, Cleverly, as well. And you two were talking about this earlier on, that without that, really, you don't have anything. And Cleverly has shown on that occasion and again tonight that he does have it. Well, again, just more action from that sixth round, and Bramer looks a pretty fine fettle there at the halfway stage of this contest. There's no real marking up particularly of either fighter just yet, but there's a fair amount of urgency in there. Cleverly again, as he has been throughout the course of this fight, quickly off his stool, quickly back to his feet. Darren Wilson in his corner. That was a change he made after that defeat to Sergei Kovalev. His father had trained him previously to that, and Cleverly maybe with just a bit of kidology at the start of the round. And has the fight been called off here due to an injury? Well, Cleverly is celebrating, as is Eddie Hearn, and Bramer as he emerged from the corner there at the end of the sixth round. It did look fairly animated. There did seem to be discussion going on, and obviously their man has been pulled out. He has been retired. That could be the only explanation for it. I'm not sure why, but that's all we can assume.
Yeah, there was something going on there in the corner. Obviously, we weren't sure. I just thought they were G'ing him up, you know, because he was obviously feeling the pace. It was it's been a hectic pace, but he didn't look like he was on the verge of being stopped or anything. He was certainly in the fight. I mean, it was, you could even have him ahead. I probably had it dead level, to be honest, but a lot of the rounds were close, and he landed a lot of very clean punches. He was certainly in the fight, and I'm very surprised to see the stoppage there, Carl.
Yeah, I saw the pace drop there from Bramer towards the end of that last round, like similar to the last minute, and Cleverly was having his success. And was it because Bramer took his foot off the gas and stopped the work rate because of an injury? Maybe he's injured his hand. A lot of shots were landed. But I scored that last round to Cleverly, and he finished the round really strong because there was nothing really coming back from Bramer. We didn't see anything that caught our eye to say he was injured. He didn't shake his hand or shake his head or look down at his corner. But there may be a broken hand or something from Bramer that's going to transpire. But we just wait and see, because the fight has been stopped here, and we're a bit confused as to why, because Bramer was more than in the fight and ahead, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I don't know if he just grimaced there as his glove was pulled off. Maybe it is a broken hand, I'm not sure, but we'll have to wait and see. But Cleverly, you know, Cleverly certainly boxed a great performance. It was a great fight to watch. I mean, I'd love to see the punch stats on exactly what was landed up to that point, but it was a hell of a pace.
Well, it's interesting, we're just watching a replay there of what happened in the corner, what was going on in the Bramer corner, and what Cleverly saw as he came back out for the start of that round. And there really didn't seem to be anything untoward going on in there at all. He's having the hand wraps cut away, Cleverly celebrating, and as you've been pointing out, it was a very even fight. It was a very good fight, and we'll get news of this. It'll come to light eventually, but maybe some kind of hand problem. But whatever happens, he is the new WBA light heavyweight champion.
Yeah, I mean, it didn't seem like there was hand trouble then when he was taking the bandages off. He seemed okay, but I suppose we'll find out. But certainly from Nathan Cleverly's point of view, he went out there, he straight out of his corner, straight over to Bramer, forced the pace, made it his type of fight, uppercuts, hooks, combinations, doubling up the left hook, really forced the pace. Bramer too, to credit to him, stood his ground, fought well on the inside. But
looking at his arm there, Bramer, Matt, sorry to cut you in, he's got the ice pack on his right elbow and his right arm. He must have injured his right arm, and what a shame for the fight fans and the viewers at home. This fight here was really heightening up. It was a great fight to watch. It was going both ways. I got Bramer just ahead. What a shame. I think the injury here to the right arm, which we'll obviously hear about and find out, has brought this fight to an end, and Cleverly is the new world champion.
Well, I'm just wondering if there was a quick conversation there between Cleverly and Bramer about maybe doing this again, because it could happen. And he's got that ice pack, as you say, clamped to the elbow, but it's a test of body, a test of mind as well. And as you get a little bit older, as you advance in years, then the wear and tear maybe kicks in. But that is obviously, now it's been revealed, that is what the problem is. And it's a shame for the spectacle, for the fight, because it was warming up. It was already a very good fight, and it promised to be a thrilling final six rounds. But just look at the smile on Nathan Cleverly's face there, because he's done something which very, very few British fighters have done. He's come to Germany and he's unseated an established, long-reigning world champion. Just a pocket of Welsh fans there who have made that journey. He lost the WBO version of light heavyweight title, of course, to Sergei Kovalev, and he's regained the WBA version. The WBA actually have ordered their super champion to fight their regular champion. Now the regular champion is Nathan Cleverly. The super champion will be either Andre Ward or Sergei Kovalev. If it's Sergei Kovalev, I'm not too sure he'd want to do that again, but he's already agreed to a fight with Ward once, so you'd imagine he would again.
Yeah, I mean, you know, like, he's just picking up from what you said there, Andy, he's won it in a very fan-friendly style, fan-friendly fight, just like the Fanfara fight was, and it's kind of really, you know, he's world champion, but he's world champion and he's won it in a great fight in Germany. It's a shame that Bramer picked up the injury, because it was really hotting up. It had been a hellacious pace. We thought it was... a very close fight on the cards, but we felt that it was Nathan Cleverley's type of fight and it was going in his direction. The longer the longer the fight played out, the more it was in his favour. But yeah, I mean, hats off to Nathan Cleverley. He's gone to Germany and beating a long-standing champion in such a fan-friendly fight, and I think he has lots of options from here.
And Carl Kallis-Owland there just saying, overheard saying that it's a dislocated elbow.
Dislocated elbow, okay. Well, he's moving the arm around. I'm very disappointed. If my arm's broken and I can't move it, then I'm going to stop fighting. But until then, I'm carrying on.
At the start of round number 7, with Jürgen Bremer in no position to continue the fight, your winner by TKO and the new WBA light heavyweight champion of the world, Nathan Cleverley.
Well, what a night for Nathan Cleverley. It hadn't finished in the way that he would have anticipated, but it doesn't matter. He came here to get the win, and the win he has got, and he is the new WBA regular world light heavyweight champion. And there the belt goes around the waist, and this is a big, big achievement. No matter how the fight finished, it's a very difficult thing to do, come to Germany and win and unseat a reigning world champion, and that is exactly what he has done. He'll now go away, have a well-deserved rest, but he will be back in more big fights. His career has still got a few more chapters yet.
Grateful to be world champion for a second time. You know, I won the world title when I was 24 and I was living the dream. I loved it, you know, being the champion of the world in the sport I love, I worked so hard for. And, you know, I lost my belt in my sixth defense, but I needed this back. I needed this belt back in my life, and I came back for it. I've worked hard, I've dedicated myself, and now I'm two-time champion of the world, and I'm so grateful.
Also, der Mann ist natürlich unglaublich glücklich. Er ist mit 24 schon mal Weltmeister geworden. Der hat ihn bei der 6. Titelverteidigung dann verloren und er hat gesagt, er braucht diesen Titel wieder. Jetzt ist er ein glücklicher Mann und er ist einfach fast, naja, sprachlos nicht, aber er ist glücklich und widmet sich diesen Titel sogar selbst. Jürgen Bremer already told me that you already agreed to the rematch. You're looking forward to this match?
Yeah, well, I'm very grateful for Jürgen Bremer for giving me the shot at the title. He's been a great champion. He had a great amateur pedigree, a great professional pedigree. But he's 37 years of age now. It's time for a younger lion to come through, the 29-year-old. Grateful for the opportunity. But one door closes, another one opens, and it's time for a new champion now. But if he wants a rematch, we've got a rematch clause. If he really wants it, you know, ultimately, tonight I broke Bremer up, you know, I broke him up the first 6 rounds. It was going one way. I was going to dominate in the second half of the fight.